Okay. Run.
Yeah. Oh, it's back. It's like a lounge. Hold on.
No, no, I'm doing it.
Oh, you are.
It's on the side, remember?
Is that as high as it can go? That's as high as it can go. Oh. The hoopty's in the dumpster now, so we don't have to worry about that raggeded...
You don't miss the hoopty, is that what you're saying?
That thing, whatever you call it. Thing. Thing. T-H-I-N-G. It's not even anything. It's a thing.
But that's mean. Mommy was actually got some hurt feelings when she saw the video where the hoopty died.
Oh. Now I kind of actually feel sad.
You feel sad now all of a sudden?
Yeah, kind of. What time is it now?
3:19. No kicking in the car with your shoes.
Sorry, just totally turned around.
Yeah, you totally like just messed up my
turn
part.
Around. Then ah! My god, why'd you do that when my seat was back? That is not funny.
That was awesome.
That was not.
Yeah, it was.
You lunatic.
Here.
I have a new name for the car.
What's the new name for the car?
Bertha.
No, it's not going to be Bertha.
Bertha. Hello, Bertha.
Okay. Oh, man, look at this and listen to this. You hear the birds chirping? You hear the birds chirping? I love it. Spring is finally here. It's a new day. Yesterday was sunny as well. If you follow this channel, you know I hate winter. Winter sucks. No car guy likes winter. Unless you occasionally can have fun in your truck. But if you have like sports cars, supercars, and stuff like that, winter is not fun. So the beginning clip of this video was just me picking up Sydney from school. A lot of you guys have been asking about Sydney. You know, why is she not in the videos more and that kind of thing. She's almost 10 now and she goes to school and full of activities. It's volleyball. It's soccer when it's soccer, it's basketball, it's drama, it's this and that and cheering. When she's in school and doing all that stuff, I'm filming. When she gets back, I'm usually editing. But there we have her. As soon as she gets out of school, I'm sure she can be in videos a little more. But now we got to cover something that I get a lot of questions about. It's kind of just a boring update because I don't have a fun update for you yet regarding the F-150. I mean, if you're an Autoblog Pro member, you've heard me bitch and whine about this already. If you follow me on social media, you've heard me bitch and whine about this already as well. The truck is still sitting here, of course, and that's all there is to it. I mean, I've been dealing with the shipping company back and forth now for over a week. The last video I made on this truck was over a week ago saying that, oh, I finally locked down a shipping company that's gonna bring it down to Florida. And regarding Florida, I guess I should cover this right off the bat here. I know I'm gonna get probably hundreds of comments in the comment section saying, like, you know, what I should be doing. Like, why are you bringing it down to Florida? Why don't you take it to a Ford dealership? Why don't you let Brian work in on it? Blah, blah, blah. I wanted to get down to a VMP. I want them to take care of the truck, which I know they will. The truck will be up and running again. I know that for a fact. We're going to retune it as well and do some fine-tuning and stuff. That's why I want to get it down to Florida. And a lot of people are like, why don't you just tow it down with the Raptor to Florida? But I don't need two trucks down in New Smyrna Beach. That's why I have a shipping company that was supposed to pick it up no later than Monday this week. It is Wednesday today. So we've been texting back and forth and they're under the impression that I only want to pay with credit card, which is untrue. I told them I can pay with cash. Since then, I haven't really heard anything. But the thing is, I've shipped cars before. We shipped my AMG out to California last year for Car Week and stuff. And it's always an issue. Everyone I know that I've talked to that ship cars, there's always an issue when you ship new cars. They're always late, always. I wanna have the truck up and running. It's days like this where it's 55, 60 degrees, boost weather, which is the reason why I supercharged the truck. So that's where we're at with the F-150. It just sits here. 750 crank horsepower, 608 to the wheels, stuck in the driveway. So that's the boring update on the F-150. We have a fun little update here that
can't tell anyone, especially my wife. And it's okay that I'm saying this on video because she doesn't really watch my videos. But in this box, we have the first surprise mod to the Raptor. We're gonna start modding the Raptor. Don't tell my wife, don't tell her.
It's a nice little beginning, something that I know that she's gonna like. So slowly but surely, we start doing some stuff to the Raptor. We're not gonna go balls to the walls crazy like we did in the F-150, but you know, we can't neglect the Raptor for the spring, summer, and fall season. But back to the F-150, now that I like talk about this and film it and it gets back on my mind, it just makes me more and more frustrated and pissed off. I know this is crappy content. This content sucks. Like, I'm filming this truck sitting in the driveway, and it's like the second video I'm filming about it sitting in the damn driveway. It's horrible. I feel a responsibility towards you guys to make content with this truck. I know you guys want to see it. I get so many questions on like Instagram and Facebook nonstop, like every day. And I'm sorry, guys, but it's still sitting here. But just logistics are what they are. Sorry. But I don't want this video to be a downer video. So we're gonna go from one frustrating vehicle in the fleet to one a lot more positive. Haha, yeah, we're driving the Mercedes, baby. This car could indeed be yours on May 6th. Now, in case you missed the previous video where I talked about how you can win this Mercedes, I'm gonna just clarify some things shortly here today. And of course, it's extremely windy outside and I have a wind protector, but sometimes I've noticed that doesn't help. So let's just jump in the car. So what I've done is I've created a membership website. It's called autovlog.pro. Now, basically, this is gonna be a VIP experience of sorts where you get access to premium content. You get all the videos 24 hours ahead of them landing on YouTube. We have a forum. Basically, I'm trying to build a community on that website, and that does not in any way mean that anything is happening to my YouTube channel. It's not like you have to pay to watch my videos on YouTube, nothing like that. But there are a couple core reasons why I created this website, and mainly it's because of the state of YouTube. If you're a creator, you might be more up to date on this kind of stuff. If you're just someone that watches YouTube videos, you might not really care as much, you know, because you don't really have to think about it. But YouTube belongs to the advertisers. That's just how it is. I mean, YouTube is its own platform, it's its own company, all this stuff. But if the advertisers say something that is concerning to them, YouTube jumps right away. What the advertisers say goes for YouTube. That's just how it is. Nowadays, people can get demonetized for absolutely nothing because of just the way that it is in the world today. I mean, people do crazy stuff, and I understand advertisers don't want their ads to end up on videos where people do stupid stuff. So long story short, I mean, I hope and I don't think anything is going to happen to YouTube, but it could. And if it does in the future, what I want is a home where I can still create content for you guys. Because, I mean, just to be honest, when you do YouTube full-time, it's your living. That's how you get paid. Even if I didn't make money from my YouTube channel, I would still make videos. But I wouldn't be able to make videos on a regular basis like I do. I wouldn't be able to make the type of content that I do with the cars that I own and so on, because things cost money. That's just how it is. This is my job. I owe, like, my career, if you want to call it that, and my lifestyle and everything to the platform of YouTube. I love YouTube. It's awesome. It's been a dream come true for me. So when I launched this website, a lot of people, they were like, oh, Mike, you're just being greedy. You don't care about your subscribers. You're just trying to make all this money, blah, 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 and all this stuff. And I mean, I don't think there's anything that I can say to change anyone's mind, because people are going to believe what they want to believe. But the fact of the matter is that YouTube is in a bit of a crazy state now. And if you're a creator yourself, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Videos, like I mentioned, can get demonetized for just absolutely nothing. I mean, YouTube has its own little weird algorithms and stuff like that, and it can pick up on anything. It's just so much stuff that you gotta think about as a creator when you're uploading content. So just think of it this way. Let's say you have a regular job. Just you go and you punch in for the day, and then at the end of the day, something was wrong in the system, the computer system, and you don't get paid for that day, and your employer says, well, sorry. You know, yeah, it was our fault, but we can't really do anything about it. You're not getting paid. So that's basically what a creator can be dealing with if their video gets demonetized while it's live. During that time when, you know, you can obviously request a manual review and they go over it. And most of the time when you do that, they're like, oh, yeah, sorry, you know, there's nothing wrong with this video. Monetized.
But during that time, you've lost a lot of income because that can take like 12 hours sometimes.
So without sitting here rambling for too long, that is the reality of YouTube today. And that's just the reality of what's going on in the world. And a lot of these issues, you can sit and go back and forth and discuss all you want and, you know, debate and all that stuff. I think that a lot of it is just oversensitivity. Like, everyone is so, you know, sensitive nowadays. You can't say anything because everyone gets offended. And then you have these real issues that are unfortunately happening. A couple weeks ago, and this is a new thing even for YouTube, they tweeted about this and everything. A video can get demonetized because of its comment section. Its comment section. Now, if you're a creator and you have a sizable channel, you know you're going to get hundreds, if not thousands, of comments in every video that you upload. And if you're someone that uploads daily, I mean, I don't. I try to do every other day. There's no way you're going to sit and moderate all these comments. What ended up happening was a YouTuber posted a video that went viral where he had discovered that disgusting human beings, horrible human beings that prey on children, you know what they're called. I'll probably get this video demonetized now because I mentioned this word. Pedophiles were having some kind of ring in comment sections of videos on YouTube, where they somehow in their sick fucking twisted way were able to communicate with each other. I didn't watch the whole video because just that was disturbing enough. I don't understand exactly how it works, but you know, when I like understand that, okay, even the comment section now can get demonetized by what other people are doing. I'm just uploading a video and then some sick freaking people can start doing their code language sick shit in my comment section. And, you know, that's just how it is. Like, how am I supposed to be able to monitor all that? I can't.
So there's been a lot of factors that have made me want to have this membership website. And again, nothing's happening to my YouTube channel. Everything stays the same. You're going to see all the content, you know, free, you know, just with some ads on it, whatever it is you do. I mean, YouTube has a subscription service as well, a premium service, where, you know, you can pay and you don't get ads, you get access to, you know, their music and TV. But basically, I wanted to create a membership website that no matter what happens, you know, for the people that are interested, there's no requirement whatsoever for you to sign up for my Autovlog Pro membership. You can just stay and watch the videos for free on YouTube if you want to. But I created this membership site so I can at least have a home, no matter what happens. That's my website. And I charge a minimal fee for this. It's $21 a year for an annual membership. You can try the site out if you want to on a monthly basis for $3 a month. Just cancel if you think it sucks or whatever and you know you don't value the perks that you get on the website. That's fine. But you know, I got a lot of hate from the first video. And they were like, Mike, you're just being greedy and blah, blah, blah. And maybe some of my wording was wrong, but my intentions are good. And like, just even a year ago, I couldn't even imagine to be able to do something like this. Now, some people, they use Patreon, you know, where they offer, you know, more perks for their subscribers, you know, exclusive content or giveaways, whatever it is. And even YouTube has an extra feature. You know, there's a join button on some YouTube channels where if you pay $5 a month or whatever it is, you get extra perks from the creator, whatever that creator chooses those perks to be. You can get emojis by your username when you comment, stuff like that. You know, a lot of YouTubers have big merch sites and, you know, they'll have like contests or giveaways where you buy merch and, you know, you can enter into a giveaway of whatever, a car or whatever it is. And I think all that stuff is great, whichever way you choose. But I chose to step away from YouTube, have a separate website where you get content 24 hours ahead of YouTube. You're going to get exclusive content from time to time that won't be uploaded on YouTube. We have a forum where people can post topics, ask questions. I'm basically just trying to create a community. That's all. And if you break down an annual membership, which is $21, like I mentioned, I mean, it's like right over $2 a month. And for those members that choose to sign up, it's not something anyone is required to do or anything like that, you can win this Mercedes right here. I am announcing the winner on May 6th, randomly, of course. You have to be from the US to be able to win this car right here. But I just wanted to try to explain a little bit what my thought process has been and what it's like for a creator. It's, you know, I understand that it's very different for someone that doesn't do YouTube. All they do is pretty much watch videos on YouTube. But when you're like a content creator and you do it full time, there's a lot of other stuff to think about.
I mean, it's not a raffle site. It's not a giveaway site. It's a membership site. And every now and then, we're going to have cool perks like this Mercedes right here. So when the car is gone, the website's still going to be there. And I'm just going to try to build that community as good as I can.
You might be like, man, screw this bald Swede. I'm not paying for nothing. I'll watch the videos for free on YouTube. That is completely fine. No worries whatsoever. But I just want to make sure that I can create content for as long as I like without YouTube, you know, dictating every little move I make. If I say something wrong, because sometimes I cuss, that's just who I am. Am I going to get demonetized for that then? Am I going to get demonetized for some sick creep creeping into my comment section and I don't notice it? Like, that stuff is scary. It is scary to me. It is sick that these disgusting fucking pedophiles can even do this type of stuff. And I understand that YouTube is on them, as they should be. And advertisers as well. I get it. I understand where they're coming from. Like, even if there's nothing wrong in the content of the video, I understand they don't want to be have ads on a video where sick human beings are running some sick rings in comment section. I get it. But this is what I do for a living. Like, I can't control all that stuff. It is what it is. And yeah, with the membership site, when I launched it, I wanted to, you know, be able to do something special for the people that, you know, choose to sign up. And that's this car right here. And hopefully I can keep doing this. All right. Enough babbling from my end here. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did and you're stopping by for the first time, please subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.